Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. We are back again with another video, that is self signaling. We are continuing it. Yesterday we have studied about the GPCR signaling pathway, and also I have told about IPP DAC pathway. Hope that part of the video was clear to you. The second part we are going to study about the enzyme linked receptor. As you remember, the extracellular receptors were divided into three parts: GPCR, second is enzyme linked, and the third one was ion channel receptor. We have already covered the GPCR portion. Today we are going to cover this enzyme linked receptor. As from this name itself, you can understand that it is linked to an enzyme. As in case of GPCR, it was linked to a G protein. In the same way, this receptor will be linked to an enzyme. That's why it is called enzyme linked receptor. It is a major cell surface receptor, like that of the GPCR. Why? It is also a transmembrane protein, and it also function as when the ligand binds to it. Okay, as the same as that of the kinase receptor. Second one is serine threonine kinase receptor, and the third one is kinase associated receptor. Okay, so the major, most abundantly which is used receptor is the tyrosine kinase receptor. Okay, tyrosine kinase receptor is the first case is tyrosine kinase receptor is also known as RTK, that is receptor tyrosine kinase, also known as receptor tyrosine kinase. So it has two surfaces, that is one towards the extracellular where the ligand bind, and below it is the enzyme where the enzyme is bind. This is the site where the ligand will come and bind, and below is the site where the enzyme is linked. Okay, and the ligand of these RTK can be of different types, such as insulin, epidermal growth factor, then platelet derived growth factor. Different types of ligands can bind to this RTK. Okay, and this consists in a dimer structure, that is two structures will be present like this. Two structures will be present, dimer structure, and to it enzyme will be attached to it. Okay, whenever this ligand will come and bind to it, they will get attached to each other and phosphorylate, and then the further signaling process will begin. Because that is one side, it will be present towards the extracellular surface where the ligand will bind. It will be present in a dimer like structure, that this here the ligand will bind, and the other surface has the kinase catalytic site, that is the enzyme site. The other side has the enzyme site, which is present towards the site. So once the ligand will come and bind to this ligand binding site, this ligand can be any type, that is growth factor, then platelet derived growth factor, okay, and insulin. Any type of ligand can come and bind here. As a result of which, what will happen? The ATP will be converted into ADP, which will lead to the autophosphorylation. That is, once they are phosphorylated, they will phosphorylate both itself. Okay, they will phosphorylate it by itself, autophosphorylation. And this phosphorylated is the active condition. This is the active condition. If you remember GPCR, when the GPCR receptor was present in the GTP condition, it was in an inactive form. And when the ligand was coming and binding, it was converting into GTP, and then the alpha and the beta gamma subunit was getting associated, then only the GPCR was getting activated and it was activating the other substances similarly. After this autophosphorylation process, it will get activated and it will activate certain other protein. Okay, and this pathway, this process is followed by different types of pathway. As we have seen, GPCR is seen in neurotransmitter, then hearing, sight, etc. Similarly, this enzyme linked receptors is followed by kinase pathway. By using this word kinase, you can understand that enzyme is used. Works under this principle also. GPCR as well as this both, they work under both the process. PI3 kinase activity. Okay, these three pathways follow the RTK process, that is receptor tyrosine kinase follows this three pathway follow this RTK pathway. Okay, type C, okay, phospholipase C, okay, it can activate certain other proteins after the activation. So now we are going to study about a very important, that is the RAS. Understanding this pathway, I want to make you understand that is RAS. What is RAS? RAS is a protein which is responsible for growth. By using serine, theta, one of the pathway which follows the enzyme linked receptors pathway. Okay, then what happens in the RAS? That is requires two protein, that is GEF and GAP. What is the role of this GEF? Guanine nucleotide exchange factor, which will be attached to this GDP state. Okay, when this RAS is in the GDP state, GEF is attached to it. Okay, then G activating factor, GTPase activating factor. Okay, it will be attached to it when the RAS is in the GDP state. So by this you can understand that when the RAS is in the inactive state, GEF is attached to it, and when it is in the active state, it is attached to the GTP. So with the help of these two proteins, this pathway occurs. So first of all, the RAS is in the GTP is attached to it, means GEF will be attached to it. Okay, is it in the inactive form because no ligand has occurred. Once the binding of the ligand, after the ligand comes and bind here, then the autophosphorylation will occur as we have discussed earlier and is known as dimeric receptor, but still it is in the inactive condition. Why? Because now it requires another two protein for its activation, that is SOS and GBR2. These two transcription factors are required for this activation of the RAS, for the liberation of RAS from this GDP. Because for the liberation of RAS from the GDP, apart from this ligand also, it requires SOS and GRB2. With this help, what will happen? Okay, what will happen? This GDP will be converted into GTP, as a result of which this RAS will get activated. This RAS will get activated. So not only the binding of ligand is required, but also this SOS and GRB will come and bind to this phosphorylated site of this RTK, and then it will activate the RAS from GTP to GTP. Okay? As a result of which the signaling pathway will start. Now this RAS is ready for the signaling process. Okay? Now this RAS is ready for the signaling process. So this is how the RAS pathway works. So this is all about RAS. Once the RAS is activated, okay, once the RAS is activated, active now, we have seen how the RAS is activated, activate another protein, that is RAF. Every step they are getting phosphorylated at serine and threonine. Okay, they will get phosphorylated and this will activate MPK, which is another protein, serine and threonine, and it will activate MAP kinase. Okay, it will activate phosphorylated in the serine and threonine, RAS MAP kinase, and also this is all about the enzyme ring receptors. There are other many types, different types, but the most important one was RAS MAP pathway, that is tyrosine pathway, we have discussed today. So the, in the next part of the video, we are going to discuss about the ion channel receptors, and by that will be the end of the cell signaling. If you want any new topic regarding to cell signaling, if you want to discuss about the GPCR vision system or anything related to that, you can ask in the comment section. And if you are new to my channel, do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel, and also share among your friends as much as you can. Have a nice day.